yo. Yuck Mouth doing it with Rick Ross and Urban Streets. You know how I do it.
Yo, 1-2-1-2, what's the deal? It's your boy Ghostface. Right now, y'all watching Urban Street TV. Y'all know what time it is, man. Don't go nowhere. Just stand still. One.
The regime general, Yuck Mouth. Y'all right, man? Rapping that mouth. Y'all right, man? Jay Prince, Scarface, what it do? SmokeLotRecords.com, log on. Y'all right, we out of here.
It's your boy YOUNGPIT out that Evergreen, man. 206-253. So old school in it, man. Young Pit coming to you real soon, man, in 06, man, with that Lockjaw and that Mr. Lee's Garden, man. Get at your boy at MySpace/YoungPit, man. Ah, I'm out of this month.
Urban Streets TV here in Seattle at the C Spot building with the one and only Ghostface, you guys. This is the man, the legend.
What's up, y'all? What up?
It's the guy here.
What's going down?
Let's get into the swing of things. You here promoting the album Fish Scales. What does Fish Scale mean?
Fish Scale. It's basically, you know, for the people that, I don't know the viewers, you know, I don't know what the age is on the viewers, though, you know. It's basically from the streets, man. You know what I mean? People that was on the streets, you know, from the hood, you know.
Right.
I got my hands dirty before I was in this game.
That's
and can I really explain it?
Oh, yeah. Get gutted. Right. It's all good.
It's like, yo, it's like, bottom line, it's like Fish Scale on the block is like the best cocaine they had on the block. That's the best coke that you could ever find. You know what I mean? But I had put it towards my album because it's like, when I was doing this album, this is my package, this is my raw, this is my dope, this is my coke that I'm trying to sell to the people in the knockoff, you know what I mean, to get the people high off my music.
That's right.
You know what I mean? So I had named it Fish Scale, you know what I mean, just based on, you know, on the street level, but took it to the music level with Fish Scale.
Yeah, because I feel you on that. A lot of people, you know what I'm saying, when they hear that, people especially that you know, listen to your music, you know what I'm saying,
yeah.
The people that are on the streets, the people that do the grinding, the people that, you know what I'm saying, have to make their living day to day, you know what I'm saying, they're gonna feel that. But how does this album separate you from other albums? I mean, of course, each time, you know, you grow in character, you learn something new, or you try something different. So how is this album different?
It's not really too much of a difference, you know
okay.
what I mean? It's like, okay. You know, I don't really try to outdo myself, which is, you know, I wish I could, you know what I mean? But it's like Ghostface just do Ghostface.
That's what's up.
You know what I mean? Because they say, yo, if it's not broke, don't try to fix it. You know what I mean? So, you know, I try to get a little bit more creative and what I could do as far as my topics, maybe certain skits here and there, you know what I mean? But a lot of things in this game, especially with me, would be holding me back a lot from my full potential, be like, you know, samples
mm-hmm.
and stuff like that get denied. Like, I might have a vision one way, and then
mm-hmm.
I gotta remove, start subtracting stuff off of the album, and it's like you can't use it. So then it starts sounding a little bit more different to me. Even if I take one thing off, it's like, for me, knowing my capabilities, is like, it hurts me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But I just did, on this album right here, I just, you know, caught that vibe, you know what I mean? Because usually when I make an album, I look for a vibe. You know what I mean? And no disrespect to no other producers, but, you know, Doom, when I bumped into him, he had that feel that I had back in the days. Like Supreme and RZA tracks, Iron Man, and all that stuff like that. He had a certain feel like that. God Bless the Dead, J Dilla too. You know what I mean? Pete Rock was still in the, he was on his grind. So, you know, I used a bunch of those producers, you know what I mean? Now,
mm-hmm.
now that's the vibe. Now I'm working with a vibe now. Now, if I, no disrespect, if I mess around and get a beat from Timbaland or something, and I put it in there, it's gonna, like, where that come from? Like, it don't
right.
fit.
Yeah.
You feel
yeah.
what I'm saying?
It's like the puzzle.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah,
you gotta
exactly.
Have it
it's not gonna
connect.
Fit. Not saying that the beat might not be good, but it might not fit. You
right,
know what I
mean? Right.
So, you know, I just worked around this vibe right here, and I caught the vibe, you know, and it's like, you know, and people gotta understand too. It's like, albums is like eras. They different eras. So every album is not always going to sound the same.
Right, that's true.
You know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's like sometimes, you know, it's what you go through. And I might be going through something like doing Iron Man, you know what I mean? When it was too soulful and it was gloomy. A lot of things was happening around that time. And you could hear it through the music, through the After the Smoke Is Clear and All I Got Is You and stuff like that. You can hear a lot of soul in it like that. You know what I mean? Now when I did Supreme, it was a lot more funner.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? As far as the skits, everything, we bugging out and having fun.
Yeah.
And I had fun on Bulletproof Wallets, but it was just that a lot of samples got taken off the album.
Right.
You know what I mean? A lot of stuff I couldn't use. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, you know, and that's how it goes. It depends on what you're going through in that era. Now, when I did Tony, the Pretty Tony joint, I couldn't really, really find what I really wanted to find.
Right.
You know what I mean? I picked the best beats that I could pick, but it wasn't really like, it was all right to me. You know what I mean? It was better than what a lot of other people be putting out there to me. You know what I mean? But, you know, it wasn't the vibe that I was really looking for. Now, this album right here is closer to the vibe of that I want the people to recognize, like, real hip-hop. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, the game kind of changed right now.
A lot of things is watered down.
Yeah, and I just wanted to bring that sound back to the people and let them get familiar with it. You know what I mean? They probably didn't hear it in a long time. Maybe if they hear it, it might be like, oh, all right, that's... I remember my dad used to play that because the generation is like little kids now.
You know
what I mean? Yep. So they don't really know. They caught up in what they seen on TV and what the radio was programming them with. So, you know, I just wanted just to take them through regular Ghostface. You know what I mean? That's so I ain't really tried nothing. I can't tell you what album is better because that's like telling me which one of my kids I like the most. You know what I mean?
You love all your children.
Yeah, of course. They all come from me. They just, you know, like I said, just
well, it just explains who you are. You know what I mean? You're the man of the music.
And at the same time, I still didn't deliver the world my best yet. You know what I mean? So it's like when God gives me that revelation and be like, okay, this is what it is right here. Then that's what it's going. I'ma know. I'm gonna be able to tell you like, yo, this is my best so far. You know what I mean?
I'm feeling that. Okay, well, before we wrap this up, what else you got going on other than the album? Anything else?
We're touring right now. We on a Fish Scale run. You know what I mean? We finished this off like around May. You know, then after that, I think I might we send a mix. We talk, me and Neo gonna probably do a tour. You know what I mean? Ooh. Probably with, you know, a few other artists. I don't want to say their names yet.
Right.
That might be sometime in, I think, June or maybe something like that.
That'll be hot.
And then what else? I got a sneaker coming out, you know, by Reebok. It's a Ghostface sneaker. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So cop that.
Go get that. That should be like in June or July too. And then the doll. I got a doll action figure that's coming right now. You know what I mean? It costs a lot of money. They're trying to put real gold on it.
Oh, wow. That's tight. I want to see that.
Yeah, that's real.
So be sure to catch them figures. Figurines, the gold. You know, they're going to be bling and they're going to be, you know, draped up and dripped out. You know what I'm saying? Right. So that's what's up.
Don't get your man back like that, yo. Hey, yo, I thought we was iller than that. All them kisses and love yous when Jay came, you hid my... It was time my brother went to war. Banged up, standing in the kitchen, yo, holding the... Sweating and breathing, bounced out of town for a weekend. Heard you had homie in the passenger seat. And honey, look, I'm a monster, Dawn. I do monster things, that's why I put your under my arm. Messing with him could bring bodily harm. And where you going hide in the streets when the... If it's one thing I learned that, never trust a female on no scale, you just confirm that. Bounce to your mama house, pack your... I don't care if you crying, you's a ruthless chick, gots to watch you. These eyeballs in my face will spot you. My girl cousins, they gon' rock you.
Come through the block in a brand new band. Knowing that thing and this dude ain't brand.
Yeah,
what I did was right.
Told you
don't get your man back like that.
I'm a good dude, you see?
Bouncing around with him up in these streets. Knowing that thing and this dude
wanna
got
play
beat. Okay, yeah, what I did was right. But you don't get your man back like that, no. Shorty, what is you thinking about? Didn't I put you down? Fly as whips, roll around like, yeah, that's the boss's chick. On the side, I might have had one or two. Them silly bras wasn't nothing on you. Rolling with him, trying to get revenge. That's what you just don't do. Come through the block in a brand new band. Knowing that thing and this dude ain't friends. Yeah, what I did
for the knucklehead.
You don't get your man back like that.
Females out there that wanna be acting like they're getting their little revenge off.
Okay.
Taking it further than what it really is, you know what I mean?
Get your man back like that. No.
Playing yourself.
Know what I mean? This dude ain't friends.
Don status, girl.
Yeah, I did whack, but you don't get your man.
You had to hold that down.
Word up. When I'm up in these streets,
but when I see money,
I'ma
hang my side down and song.
Yeah, I did whack, but you don't get your
and
man
not because
back
of you
like
neither.
No.
Believe that. It's real.
Yes, yes. I mean, yeah, man. Third Eye Design. Third Eye Design. RDEYEDZINE.com.
What's up? It's your man Logix, Urban Streets Television, Mac DVD, you know what I'm saying? Your man Street Academy. You know what I'm saying? I'm with my man right now, Cap One.
Cap One, Chi-Town's finest. You already know we out here. What's happening?
Doing good, man. What you been up to, bro?
Grinding, you know what I'm saying? Had the Motown situation, had to move home now with Warner Brothers. Shout out to Warner. The album, you know what I'm saying, to be out this summer. The mixtape, Killing the Streets, I got it for cheap. Killing the shot, we out here politicking, you know what I'm saying? Just getting it in out in Vegas. Hella women. Out here doing it big, you know what I'm saying? Love is love worldwide, you know what I'm saying?
We have a lot of local artists that, you know, are trying to get it to your level, trying to get to that point where they are able to put out tracks and they're able to be successful. Do you have any type of, you know, advice, any type of personal struggle that you can give to them that might make it a little bit easier, give them a little more insight on how to get to that level? You know what I'm saying? They're a lot of people are lost. You know what I mean? They'll put out the albums, they'll do this, they'll go through the steps, but they still end up empty handed. So is there anything that, you know, you could give to them that might give them a little more game to step their game up?
It's like, it depends on where you're at, if you're trying to really step your game up making this music and trying to get far. You know, first of all, you gotta be where it's popping. If it's not popping in your town, then you know, it's gonna be real hard for you. You know what I mean? For us, I'm from New York, so it was kind of easy to get to the radio stations and, you know, in the colleges and all that stuff, college radio and stuff like that. You know what I mean? But if you somewhere far and it's like, you know, no record labels and, you know what I mean? You don't know where the radio station is at, and it's like, you know, you gotta be where it's happening. You gotta be even in the clubs where the celebrities is at. You gotta get numbers, contact numbers, you know what I mean? You know, and start making your moves. You know, going to the record stores, putting your album in the stores, you know what I mean? Letting them like, if it's $3, yo, you keep $1.50, I'll keep $1.50, you know what I mean?
Right.
Whatever. Go ahead and just try to sell us whatever. And that's what we did. We came up, we pressed up our own records because we went to the record companies and nobody wanted us.
Of course.
You know what I mean? They said, there's too many of y'all, what are we gonna do? Nah, it's not gonna work, and this and that and the third. We said, all right, put our money together, went to the plant, pressed it up, and then we hit the college radio, we hit record stores, we did all that. Before you know it, the same companies that denied us was calling us back.
Yeah.
For let's meet again.
Yeah.
You know, and now the ball was in our corner. And then now we just did what we had to do with that ball. And that's where we at right now. We got denied too, so don't get mad if you get denied or get turned down. We've been right in the same shoes. So, but you gotta like really want it. You gotta struggle. You gotta work hard at it and just go for it. You know what I mean? Because like I said, with destiny, it's gonna come to you. It's gonna come to you. If not, then you know. But you gotta work. You know if you really want that.
That's what's up. Okay. Well, last thing. I think we're good. It's your girl, Kanika Clemens, here with the one and only Ghostface here on Urban Streets TV, showing you the hottest celebrities, the hottest local acts, the hottest everything here at the C-Spot Media Group building. So keep your channel locked on channel 76, and we out.